'Tis the season for seasonal beers, so tonight I am having Jingle Bell Bock, which is a Bavarian Doppelbock from Fort Garry Brewing in Winnipeg. Not a lot in the way of tasting notes on the can. They say it's brewed from finest German Munich and Pilsner malts. That's interesting. Almost sweet. As I did last year during December, I am going to try and relax from this kind of stressful time of the season and just do a few nice, fun, relaxing little kit builds. Starting with this one, which I got in a mailbag about 2 or 3 weeks ago, I guess. So just a nice little single-sided circuit board. Very generous tracks, good-sized pads on it. Decent silk screen, tells you where you're going, so you don't need a schematic or plans or anything, which is nice. So in the kit, we have a bunch of LEDs. There's 5 of them. When I first opened them in the mailbag, a few of them just rolled off into the nether regions of my workbench, but there are indeed 5 of them. A couple of capacitors, the resistors, little electret microphone. And what are these little transistors? S9014. Those are a fairly common little generic NPN transistor. So there's nothing complex here. Probably be a pretty good beginner circuit. It can be found on eBay and probably other places under title something like this: Electronic Funny Kits Voice Controlled LED Melody Light DIY Kits. Nice and cheap. Not too many components. The description down below is not the most descriptive. Power from the input. It's got a filtering cap for road use. Woohoo! Microphone, sound signals into electrical signals, coupled through C2, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, 5 LEDs. The greater the sound, the LEDs, lights brighter. Sure. 3 to 4.5 volts. I'll have to keep that in mind for later just so I don't blow things up. But let's take a closer look at it. So we have the 5 LEDs in parallel, going to the positive voltage. They are driven out of the collector of Q1, which is in sort of open collector kind of setup here. Pull up a 10k resistor on the base. The base goes straight off the collector of Q2. And as it said, Q2 is amplifying the microphone signal. We've got a meg resistor, a 1 meg resistor there, just pulling it down. We've got the coupling capacitor C2 there. And the microphone gets its voltage through this 4.7k resistor to positive and then to ground there. Then that is, wait a minute, where's the capacitor? That is C2, which is the coupling capacitor over there. C1 is there. Oh, that's why I didn't trace it out. It's not actually connected. The webpage said it's a power supply filtering capacitor, so I think I will just bodge it across. I think that's the positive rail right there. Yeah. So if I just bodge it across to there, that should make it a power supply filter. Right. So maybe not the perfect beginner kit because there's that little mistake there, but what are you going to do? It was fairly easy to figure out. Since this is such a tiny board, I think I'm going to old school on it and just use ye old helping hands, just like everybody has. Get a bit of moisture onto my sponge. I know all the cool kids these days like to use the copper wool or wire wool or whatever it's called, the brass wool maybe. I'm not offended by that, and I will be using it too, but I'm pretty old school, so I will also be using the moistened sponge method for cleaning my tip. Regardless of how you do it, a clean soldering tip is a happy soldering tip. So shall we start with the star of the show, the microphone itself? Drop that into the middle hole there. Got one finger underneath holding it to the board. That's an inadequate amount of solder, but that way I can focus on what I'm doing a little bit better here. What next from the pile of components? How about resistors? Some people who aren't colorblind might try and read the stripes. That's not me. There is a 10K. you go over here. That is the 4.7K. That goes over on this side. My hand in your way? Yes, completely. Oh well. So it goes. And that must mean that this one, if they've shipped it correctly, is the 1 meg. 1.0 meg. Perfect. That just goes right up here across above the microphone. Can't even see the hole that's supposed to go into. Nice thing about old school through-hole components like this is you don't have to be all that precise. They're really good for beginners or people who are rusty at soldering. And honestly, I don't do as much soldering as I used to at one point in history, so it's nice and low stress as compared to trying to hand solder those little surface mount components that are all over the place these days. So the two capacitors, there's a 1 microfarad, which goes over on that side, negative towards the top. And this one is a 47 microfarad. So that's nice. The kit actually has all the correct components in it. Some of these cheap kits you get don't have all the right components or all the components that they suggested. Sometimes they've made a substitution just because. And sometimes they've just made a mistake. Sometimes it is actually an upgrade to the kit. So you never entirely sure when they've made substitutions, but in this case, we don't have to stress about it. What we do have to think about now, though, is on this little power supply filtering stability type capacitor, where are we going to pick up that positive feed? I could just bend it over and tack it onto there. That might be the cleanest, or I could scrub some of the solder resist off that track right there. I think I might. Do it that way. Just to be neat and tidy. Which means I probably should find that power connector next. Plug him in. Can I do this without flipping the board over and seeing what I'm doing? Do it blind? Can I? Yes, okay. Capacitor wire also buried in there. And I'll solder the capacitor down to there just for mechanical stability. Did that flow on there? Yeah, I'm pretty sure it did. Definitely now. What's next? LEDs or transistors? Let's stuff those LEDs in there next. So flat side is the short lead is there. It's got a little flat on the silkscreen. I'm going to slam those right down tight against the board. Spread them out. And just jam all 5 of those dudes in there. I could leave them standing off, but I don't mind that they're right tight down to the board. And me splaying out those legs isn't gripping them down super tight to the board either. I am going to have to press up on them when I'm soldering them. That just keeps them from falling out every time I turn the board upside down. Various different ways of going about this. And since I'm just doing this for fun, I don't have to stress too much about proper. I'm just making it work. Whatever seems right at the time. I'm just going to hold it from the other side. And tack down 1 leg on each one. Hopefully getting them nice and straight to the board. The benefit of doing 1 leg at a time is you can come back and reflow them before you make it permanent. It's not bad. They're actually more or less straight. bend a couple of them here. There we go. Sure. Now I'll solder down the other leg and they are where they need to be. The forest of leads to get through there, but I got it. Do I? I don't know. There's something to be said for clipping the forest of weeds out of the way while you're going here. Did I miss any? What do we got here? There's a couple that I'm going to want to retouch, but first I'll get some of this out of the way so I can actually get to them properly. That one was horribly ugly. And that one wasn't great. Cut that one a little short. There, that's just fine. Get that resistor again just cause. Right then, just the two transistors to go in. As I said, this is a super simple and kit, which is the perfect thing for just sitting down for a while with a drink and soldering up just for the fun of the activity. And that should be all the soldering. I don't see any unintentional short circuits there. Everything seems to be connected. Let's connect that power connector up to the power supply. 3 volts. I think that was the voltage that it said was reasonable. I'm going to turn the current up to, let's say maybe 100 and some milliamps. Connect this guy in there, and the red wire does go to positive input. You can just barely see it over there on the board. Let's see what happens. It's on. Is it drawing any current at all? No. And it's not doing anything. Awesome. So, troubleshooting phase begins. Why is that meter showing impedance across where the power should be coming in? I got the meter turned, the power turned on, right? Yeah, I got my 3 volts there. So there's my ground, which should be there. Yeah, pretty much a short. Means that side should be 3 volts. Yes, it is. Okay. Okay. So what's happening here? That's power, right? Yes. Power's getting all the way around to the LEDs. Yes. And there on the LEDs, yeah. Where else should power be getting to? Power's getting to the resistor. The power there. That's 0.6 volts. That is the base. That's right. 0.6 volts makes sense for a base junction. Let's try the base of the other one. 0.14. Right, because it's connected to the collector of this guy, right? Yeah. Everything's making a certain amount of sense. That is, what is that? That is the drive to the LEDs. Why is that showing as AC voltage? Oh, okay. It's working now. Did I just have a bad power connection? Oh, man. A wise man once said of troubleshooting, always check the easy things first. Right, so it's working now. Bang, bang, bang. Yeah. So this is... How many times have I said that? It's a simple little circuit. Could be useful, I suppose. A silence detector or the opposite of a silence detector? Sure. It could, if you wanted a single channel color organ being one of those disco flash the lights to the music automatically kind of things. And actually, remember this guy? It has a flash to the music mode. There's a little microphone right in there. So it's not an unheard of thing. It's a fun enough little circuit. Now then, how could you modify or expand this? Well, you could put bigger LEDs on it, obviously. You could chain another transistor or a MOSFET or something off there and drive something really big and bright if you wanted to. I don't know. It's a couple of simple things. And like I said, the circuit is pretty straightforward. So I don't know. It could be very beginner friendly circuit. You breadboard that up pretty easily. It's all common components, or I mean, you get two or three of the kits if you just wanted the components too, rather than buying them, because it's less than $2 for the kit. Anyway, that was fun. I enjoyed just chilling out, making a simple little kit. And as I've done in previous Decembers, I think I will probably do a few other kits. Nothing this basic. I've got a couple of better kits, better, bigger, stronger, faster, louder, I don't know, more intense kits anyways that I'm going to do over the next couple of weeks, just because I like doing kits. They're relaxing and I don't need extra stress in December. Thanks everybody for watching. As always, I do appreciate it. If you have any comments or questions, down below in the comment section. Till next time, I'll talk to you later.